Hello everyone, welcome to Just Learn Civil. Please subscribe for updates. This is problem on analysis of beam in SAP2000. We would analyze this beam of this loading in SAP2000. We would follow these steps to analyze the beam in SAP2000. Open SAP, then click on new model. You can change the unit from here. We will use kilonewton meter. C means for temperature degree Celsius. Then select the template. We will select grid. Leave it as it is. Go to exit plane. You can work on any plane here because it is beam. Double click on any of the grid line. We need only three grid here, A, B and C. The spacing between them is 4 meter and 7 meter. Let's input the spacing. You can also do it by ordinates. If we do it by ordinates, then this is 0, 4 and same for 11. Scroll your mouse to zoom in and out. We have completed step 1. Now let's draw members. There are two ways of drawing members. Go to draw menu, then click on draw frame cable tendons. Click on two points where you want to draw. Then escape. Another way of drawing is select it, press delete, then go to draw, quick draw frame cable. You don't need to click on two points here, simply click on the grid line where you want members. Escape. Step 2 is completed. Now let's draw support. Now we would assign support to each joint. First joint has joint A as hinge, B roller and C fixed support. Select the joint. This is A joint. Then go to assign joint restraints. Hinge restraints translation in Z direction and X direction. So 1 for X, 2 for Y, 3 for Z. Then restrain in X and Z. You can also do it from here, fast restraint. We don't need anything to do with Y axis because we are working in XZ plane. Press apply. Okay. Select joint B. Roller will restrain only in its plane perpendicular. That is Z. Fixed support will restrain in X, Z. Translation in X, Z, rotation about Y axis. You can see here as star. If you select this, all the 6 are checked. If you select this, 3 are checked. If you select this, then only Z is checked. None are checked. If you select different combination other than these given, then you would get the symbol as star. Now let's go for step 4, loading. We need to apply UVL from 0 to 2 meter of maximum 10 kN per meter. Be careful to select the unit at the beginning of the modeling because you cannot ladder. Now if you select another unit, then only there will be conversion. Like 4 meter now would be 4000 mm ladder, but not 4 mm ladder. Now applying UVL 0 to 2 meter with maximum of 10 kN per meter. Our unit is in kilonewton and meter, so we don't need to change it. We need to apply frame load. Joint load means when we apply in the joint. But now we need to apply in the members. So we would go to select the member. Either you select negative value or gravity. Gravity means pointing downward, or minus z, which will also be pointing downward. We need to apply force, not moment. So select force. You can apply globally or locally. Now we would be applying globally. Before applying load, let's create a loading pattern. The self multiplier should be set to 0. If it is set to 1, then it will calculate the self weight of the members and add it and analyze. We don't need to do anything with the self weight of the members now, so we will put it now 0. Click OK. Now let's apply load to this member 0 meter to 2 meter. At 2 meter, there is 10 kN per meter, at 0 meter, 0. Distributed load, then under the trapezoidal load, enter at 0 meter we need 0 kN per meter, at 2 meter we need 10 kN per meter. Remember, you can also input as 10,000 meter per meter and press enter. It will accept in the unit mentioned here. It's like every text block is a calculator in itself. Add to the existing load or replace the existing load or delete the existing load. Replace the existing load means if there are any load on this member previously assigned, then that will be replaced by this new load. If you click on add, then previously assigned will remain as it is and the new will be added to it. For now I will do it, replace the existing load. You can scroll to zoom in and out. You can see here the UVL has been assigned as in the question. We need to assign UDL, uniformly distributed load, in second member. You can do it directly from uniform load. 5 kN per meter or 5000 newton per meter. You can use relative or this. Relative means like if you want to place load at the midpoint, then you can put 0.5, at quarter then 0.25, at 3/4 distance then 0.75, and put the load value here. Absolute means directly inputting the value, like 0 meter, 2 meter, 4, not in ratio. Press apply. Now we need to apply concentrated load 20 kN 3 meter from support B. Point load. You can use relative or absolute. For relative, you would have to use 3/7. But for absolute, you can use directly 3. I would use absolute. And then click on add to the existing, otherwise previously assigned load will be replaced. Right click on any member. Then click on the loads. You can see point loads and distributed load has been assigned. Right click on this member, loads, UVL has been assigned. Step 4 is completed. Now we would analyze it. Also, if you need to apply moment at any point, then you can apply it in a similar process as the loadings. Like you need to apply moment at only one point, then load type would be moment and put the value at what distance you want. Analysis. You don't need to run model. Only one load pattern. Now let's view the result. You can see here the reaction joint. Now if you want the stress or force, you can click it. Only one load pattern. This is the diagram for shear force. Moment to show values. Click on any member, right click on any member. You can also see value at every point by sliding this. The value here changes. Suppose I want value at this location, then you can see the shear force, moment. Remember, V2 is the measure shear force and M3 is the measure moment. You can also see the deflection here. At any point, if you want to enter the location, you can do that. Suppose I want 2 meter or 5 meter, you can do it directly from here. you can click which fortress or stresses you want. Show maximum, then it will show the maximum value of shear force, moment and deflection along with their position. Like M33 moment occurs at 7 meter at the end, then B22 also at the end, and the deflection at 3 meter. You can change to the unit. There was no axial force, so nothing would be shown here. This is how you can analyze the beam, know the reaction, shear force, bending moment diagram, deflection at any point. You can also see the deformed shape. Deformed shape of the beam. To show the undeformed shape, click here. Analysis is also complete. Thank you for watching. Please leave a comment if you have any further questions, and please subscribe for the updates.